Thank you, Father, for another time like this. We give you praise. Thank you, Lord, because you are God. You are worthy to be praised. Thank you, Father, for another opportunity to come to us with your word. Thank you, Lord, for enlightening us by your word. Thank you, Lord, for filling us with your life and your word. Thank you, Father, because you enliven us, you renew us, you strengthen us, and you save us daily by your word, Lord God, which is alive and active. Even today, Lord, we ask, Lord, that you make us fertile lands where your word will grow and bear fruit, Lord. That your word will grow in our hearts, Lord. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Let us open our Bible quickly to Philippians chapter 4. Philippians chapter 4. And verse 8, Philippians chapter 4 and verse 8, awesome scripture. And it says, finally, brethren, whatever thing is true, whatever thing is honorable, whatever thing is just, whatever thing is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is commendable, if there is any excellence, if there is anything worthy of praise, think about these things. Amen. So we are continuing our conversation from yesterday on laying aside every weight. Yes, laying aside every weight. And we're looking at this from the self. Now, why is this important? You know, yesterday we talked about the fact that if you're on the program of losing weight, you have to look at what you need to deny yourself, what you need to do differently, what you need to stop yourself from, the binging, you know, the exercise that you need to take, looking at your body structure, knowing what is fitting, what can easily make you grow that weight, and you begin to eat at the art of these things, and gradually you begin to have the kind of body weight that you think is worthy and that you think you should have. Now, in our conversation today, we need to understand that the state of our soul is very important. Yes, it is. Beloved, it is. Because you see, for many of us, what we are looking for is that peace of mind, that contentment. Hallelujah. We are looking for that thing that can give us the peace, the joy that we want. Hallelujah. And that's where the state of our soul comes into bearing. Yes, because you see, beloved, the state of our soul is dependent on what, the state of our soul is dependent on what occupies our mind. Yes, what do you occupy your mind with? See, if it is the self preoccupation that occupies your mind, my dear friends, my beloved brethren, peace and contentment will never be for you. See, forget everything about joy. You can't have it because the soul does not find satisfaction in itself. Yes, the soul is designed to find supreme satisfaction in the Lord. If you go to 1 Timothy chapter 6 and verse 17, that scripture is very clear. It says, as for the rich in this present age, charge them not to be haughty, not to set their hopes on the uncertainty of riches, but on God who richly provides us with everything to enjoy. Yes. Hence, in Hebrews chapter 12 that we read yesterday, in the verse 2, scripture says that we're looking up to Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. He said, who for the cross set before him did not bother about looking at the things, the challenges that it needed to do. He said, but he looked up to that cross. He carried it irrespective of the fact that it wasn't his desire, but he knew that for the glory that was going to come, he needed to do just that. Hallelujah. The soul is designed, my friends, for worship. It is designed for worship. So, and you cannot worship yourself. No, that would be self-preservation, self-preoccupation. Because you see, we can never find in ourselves what we are looking for. We are constantly searching in others, in society, for something that is engaging enough to keep us. Hallelujah. So it means, therefore, that self-improvement effort, self-indulgence, self-disillusion just revolves. It keeps us in a circle where we keep going in the same circle, in an hopeless labyrinth of deception, of self-worship, where we are looking for in ourselves what is never available. Hallelujah. So it means, therefore, that we must engage in laying aside our old self if we must get that joy, if we must find place for that peace that we constantly seek. Praise the Lord. But you see, there is help. There is. But this help also requires an effort from me, from you. One of the ways of achieving this is to understand the place of denial. See, Christ said this in Matthew chapter 16, 24 and 25, that if anyone would come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. For whoever would save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. Yes, you must get your eyes off yourself. You are denying yourself of the things that seemingly are so important, because there is a greater good, a greater glory. Hallelujah. And as Hebrews chapter 12 and verse 2 says, we must look up to Jesus, who is the author and finisher of us. And see, the beautiful thing is that in Matthew chapter 6 and verse 33, scripture is clear that if we seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, then every other thing will be added unto us. Hallelujah. That's the assurance we have in Christ. And because self-preoccupation by focusing ourselves does not give us that thing that we're looking for, because the soul is designed for worship and it cannot worship itself, it means, therefore, that we must find purpose in serving others. Must find purpose in serving others. But you see, some of us are dealing with challenges and the things we are binging on that is difficult to break free of. And that's where the spiritual discipline of fasting comes in. The purpose of fasting is to draw our heart towards God and reinforce that he is what we ultimately need. So by intentionally saying no to the smaller things, like a meal, we can grow the muscle we need to say no to bigger things, like the weights and the sin that hangs on our neck and wants to pull us downhill. See, God loves you and he wants to work miracles with you. But you need to allow him coming into your life and sup with you. So call the numbers on the screen. I'll be there to pray with you. As Jesus leads the way, God bless you. Amen.